Now, I am going to tell you the different calculation or the different values according to which it is easy for us to make the calculation of a particular object. Okay. So, the first one says that 1 meter is equals to 10 decimeter. Okay. 1 decimeter is equals to 10 centimeter, and 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. Okay, so these are the different scales. This is how the scale is being classified. 1 meter is equals to 10 decimeter, 1 decimeter is equals to 10 centimeter, and 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. So now, suppose if I have to find 1 meter is equals to how many centimeter? So what am I going to do here? So I know 1 meter is equals to 10 decimeter, and 1 decimeter is equals to 10 centimeter. So it means that 1 meter will give me 100 centimeter. Okay? So, did you understand, children? So, here I just calculated this into this, because 1 meter will give me a value of 10 decimeter, and 1 decimeter gives me a value of 10 centimeter. So, I need to value the value of 1 meter in terms of centimeter. So, 1 meter gives me 100 centimeter. Say, for example, if I have to find out the value of 5 meter is equals to how many centimeter, then what will I do? I will use this table. So, 5 into 100 is equals to 500 centimeter. So this is my derivation number 1. Okay. The next one says, now if you have to find out what is 1 meter is equals to how many millimeter. If I have to find out 1 meter is equals to how many millimeter. We know that 1 meter is 100 centimeter, right? And 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. So, what we have to do here? So, which means that 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. So, 10 into 100 is equals to 1000 millimeter. So, 1 meter is equals to 1000 millimeter. This is my derivation number 2. Okay. Are you clear? So, 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, and 1 meter is equals to 1000 millimeter. Are you clear with this, children? So, this is in terms of meter and centimeter. Then now, the next one we will come in terms of gram and kilogram. Okay. So, now if we have to look out for a bigger object. So, as I said, this is only for a smaller units, right? These are the arbitrary units which we use for small values. Now, coming to a bigger value. If we have to find out the value for the standard units. Okay. So, the next derivation which comes as 1 gram is equal to 100 milligram. Okay. Therefore, 1 kilogram is equals to how much gram? Is equals to how much milligram? So, how you will find out? 100 into 100 is equals to 1. Okay. So, 1 kilogram is equals to 1 lakh milligram, because we know that 1 kilogram is equals to 1000 gram. This is my third unit of measurement. 1 kilogram is equals to 1000 grams. Is it clear? So, the next one comes in terms of liter. Liter, as I said, we use the L and ml, right? So, for liter, it comes in 1 liter is equals to 1000 milliliter. This is my fourth derivation. 1 liter is equals to 1000 milliliter. If we have to find out the capacity of the bucket which holds water, okay, we will be calculating in terms of liters. We have to find out what is the capacity of the container which holds milk. What is the capacity of the container which holds water? Your water bottle's capacity. We will be calculating it in terms of liter and milliliter. Is it clear, children? So, shall we proceed further? So, based on these findings, we will be solving our sums and coming to the conclusion. Okay?